Hi everyone, Cody here showing you an easier way to stream to Twitch using OBS test build 10.1 and your Hauppauge HD PVR device. So let's go check it out.
Alright, first things first. To get the test build, follow the link that I've left for you in the description. It'll lead to github.com, and from here you can choose whatever test build you want. For us, we're going to go ahead and choose the 10.1. So you can either do the installer or the WinZip. Once you click on that, it'll automatically download to your download file, and you can go ahead and move it to wherever you wish. For me, I put it on the desktop, and with this zip file, using either 7-zip or WinRAR, you can go ahead and extract the files to wherever you wish. Once again, I've put it on the desktop just for ease of use. Once you got that, you can go ahead and click in the new folder you've just created, and in here you want to choose bin, and whichever operating software you're on. For me, I'm using 64-bit, so always make sure to run that one, and in here you'll see a whole bunch of different links. Make sure you click on the OBS 64 EXE and go ahead and start it. And if you want to, you can go ahead and right click it and add a shortcut, which I'll do for ease. Alright, so here it is. Test build 10.1. So let's go ahead and check out the settings first. As of my last video, I'll just give you a general overview. So right here, general, pretty self-explanatory. You get your theme, darker default. I'll stick with the default for right now. You've got your stream, and once again, it's always best to use the server that's closest to you. So for me, it would be LA, California. And to access your stream key, you can go to your Twitch profile and sign in. And once there, you want to go to the sidebar and click on Dashboard. Once that loads up, go ahead and hover over Stream Key and click it. And then go ahead and click Show Key and copy and paste that into here. Now, with my last video, I warned you that anyone can use this key to broadcast your channel, so just make sure you keep that hidden. You don't want anyone else to have that. Otherwise, they will hijack your stream, and that'll be no good for anyone. So moving on, over to output. A really nice thing about this is that they've simplified everything. You didn't have to go in there and add the video bitrate, audio bitrate, and all that. It's pretty much done for you, unless you choose the advanced tab, which will give you all of these. But for me, I'm just going to stick with simple. And the only thing I've really changed on this is the recording path, which you can add your own folder in your video files or wherever to designate where the streams and recorded footage will go to. Onto the audio tab. This is pretty streamlined as well. The only thing I've really touched so far is the sample rate, which I've moved up from 44 over to 48, and the channels. It was originally on mono, so I moved it over to stereo. But you'll see that you can add many different auxiliary and microphones, which is kind of cool, and you can also enable push to mute and push to talk for all of your sources. For video, you can either choose Open3D11 or OpenGL, whichever you prefer. And on the base resolution, it's always best to use the highest that your computer can do. That way you have more options to move around what you want your stream to look like. For me, I have the highest set at 1600 by 1900, or 900, sorry. And I have it scaled down to 1280 by 720 because that's pretty much the standard for any kind of streams. And for the downscale filter, I have Lanczos, which in my opinion is the best. It makes it look really nice. And over here, for the frames per second, you can choose between common, integer, or fractional. And you have plenty of options to choose from. Over here, we got the hotkeys, which you can add anything that you would personally like. For me, I just use the start recording, which is Control, Alt, and Space, so whenever I press those keys, it'll either start up my stream or end my stream. You can also choose how to switch a scene, how to show it, and all that. Anyways, the Advanced tab, it's pretty simple right now. It is still a test build, so they're still adding stuff in, and more stuff will be seen in the future. But
alright, so to create your layout, what you want to do is go to the left panel, Scenes, and either press the green plus arrow, or right click and press add, and we can add a scene. Once you've done that, make sure that that scene is highlighted, and then move over to sources. And the same thing applies there, green plus sign, or right click and add. Now from here we have plenty of sources to add, but we'll start with the webcam first. So let's go down to video capture device, click on that, we can name this webcam. Now in here, on my webcam it kind of destroys my computer. So what I want to do is go down to resolution and FPS type and change that from device default down to custom. Now mess with the resolution. Let's see, that ought to be fine. And for the frames per second, I don't really touch that because I just want to make sure there's no hardware issue at all. Now for video format, you can choose any of these types. I don't know them personally, so I won't go into them. And for the color space, you've got plenty of choices there again. And let's move things around on the desktop here, just to help make some more space. Now then, let's go ahead and add the Hauppauge device itself. So same thing, green plus arrow, and this time we'll add another video capture device. But this time it'll be Hauppauge. Once you're in there, highlight device, and then go down to Hauppauge Sienna Video Capture. And then click OK. Now it may take a second or two, so don't worry if it doesn't come up immediately. Just keep clicking on it, pressing OK. It'll show up eventually. There we go. And let's go ahead and move this down quite a bit, because it takes up a lot of room. Now, what you'll see if you try to stream immediately is that your webcam, microphone, and gameplay are not synced up at all. Just for an example, if I were to press up on this, it takes roughly a second and a quarter to actually get there. So to fix that, what we can do is add a filter to the webcam. So we'll highlight the webcam, right-click, and go to Filters. Now in here, we can add, under audio-video filters, we can go ahead and add a video delay. Video delay async. Now, for my webcam, it delays maybe a second and a quarter or so, but that will not be the same number for you, I can guarantee. So for me, I'll put 1250, and that should fix that. Another cool thing that you'll see here, this green blanket right here, we can add a chroma key, which what that means is anything that's within this blanketed area will actually be erased from the webcam live during the stream, which is pretty cool. So we'll go down to Effect Filters, right-click that, Add, and we'll add a chroma key. And let me mess with this real quick. Now for the similarity number, you want to make sure that it's just enough to gray this area out completely, but not add any fuzziness to your background, like so. So we'll go ahead and bring that down to 425, I believe. And you'll see what this does in live. So anywhere where this blanket goes that we've chroma keyed out, it'll erase completely from the video stream, which is pretty cool if you want to have a more professional looking stream. Now as you see, because we added that video delay, the webcam and Hauppauge are actually in sync. Now to fix the microphone, what you want to do is go up to the top left of the window and click on Edit, Advanced Audio Properties, and then find your microphone, which for me, and you want to add the proper delay. So kind of a rule of thumb, I just do the same delay that I put on for the webcam. So 1250, then right click that. Once you get that done, you'll have the audio, webcam, and gameplay side all in sync, which is nice. All right, that should just about do it for me. If I missed anything, or if you just want to leave your Twitch channel in the comments below, go ahead and do so. And have a nice day.